Merlin. So, thanks very much, Dave. Just like to introduce Merle Friedrichsen, the German National Library Science and Technology, speaking on open source tools in a digital archive workflow.
Thank you.
It's yours.
Yes, that's right.
Okay.
Thank you. So, my name is Merle Friedrichsen, and I work at the German National Library of Science and Technology in Hanover. I have a short presentation on open source tools in a digital archive workflow, or rather two stories on how and when we validate formats. This is soon-to-be doctor. He's really proud of himself because he just has finished his dissertation. So the only last thing he has to do is he has to hand it over to the library team. Well, the library team gets the dissertation and catalogs it, and then it gives the PDF to the digital preservation team. And we ingest it into our digital archive. Yeah, we would like to have only well-formed and valid PDFs, and this is where we have the first requests onto software validating formats. It has to be easy to implement into our existing SIF software and workflows. Yes, at this point, we do validate the PDF. Unfortunately, the PDF from soon-to-be doctor doesn't fulfill our requirements. So, We tell this the library team, and the library team then tells soon-to-be doctor, well, your PDF isn't what we want to have. So it would be really nice if the library team themselves could validate the PDF. And so what they would want to have is a simple graphical user interface from the same software that is implemented into our digital archive. It would be really nice if the tool would not only check against our chosen standard, but also against other requests that we have. For example, we don't have a strict policy, but we don't want it to be encrypted, so there shouldn't be a password on the PDF. But there would be an even better solution if soon-to-be doctor himself could test the PDF, whether it's valid or not. So it would be really nice to have a web service where soon-to-be doctor could upload his PDF, and the web service then would tell him, oh, it's not what we want it to be like. And it would be really great if it had also a repair button, so he could just click on repair and ta-da, some magic happens and the PDF is well-formed and valid. I know that a repair function won't work for all errors that can occur in a PDF, but it would be really nice and to have that. And for some errors, it might be possible to have that. And it would also be great because at the moment we would tell soon-to-be doctor, hey, you can use this other tool, but you have to install it on your laptop or somewhere else. So it would be nice if we wouldn't force him to install a tool, another tool. So there's another story I have brought to you. This is Future Me. And we have a project where we want to digitize films, a collection of films, ethnological films. So I want to prepare the formats requirements and write these into the call for proposals. Then, of course, there would be a service provider who is going to digitize the films, and hopefully they are considering all the requirements that we have in the call for proposals. So the service provider would then return all the films, the digital and the real films, and afterwards we would collect all the metadata, the descriptive, technical, and legal metadata, and ingest the films into our digital archive. The requirement, though, is once again that the software is easy to implement into existing software and workflows. And it would be really helpful if all the tests if we could define policies, our own policies, and general policies, like it has to be FFV1. And it would be nice if it would use standards for reports so that we can easy integrate the reports into our digital archive. But of course, we would want to see if the files fulfill our requests before we ingest them into our archive, so that in case they do not, we can complain on an early stage. For this, we do need software to perform fast on a large amount of files, and it would be nice if we could just automate it on a command line interface. On the other hand, it would be really sad if we had to complain about the files, because obviously we stated all our requests in the call for proposals. So it would be great if we had not only written them down there, but if we also had a machine-readable policy with all our requirements that we could just hand over to the service provider, so that they could check the files upon creating them. Yeah, around these two stories, we have evaluated two software tools, Vera PDF and MediaConge, if they fulfill our requirements. And Vera PDF is for validates PDFA files, we haven't tested yet if it is easy to implement into our existing software and workflow, but for our software that we use at the German National Library of Science and Technology, there is a user group, and this user group is going to establish Vera PDF as an out-of-the-box plugin. So this should be feasible. We've tested the simple GUI and the command line interface. We tested the checking against standards and against our own custom policy, because as I already said, we created our own policy that just checks whether the PDF is password encrypted or not. It uses standards for reports. It is an XML report, so we can easily integrate this into our other reports. It performs fast on a large amount of files, depending on what you want to test. I haven't seen a web service yet, but I think I'm quite sure that someone could make it. And it has a repair possibility, but we haven't tested it out yet. So for example, if a PDF file states that it is a PDFA file, and it is not, because it is not conforming to the standards, then it could just remove the PDFA flag. And there are some other repair possibilities. But, as I said, we haven't tested them out yet. But it is possible. And then we've tested MediaConge for the files. Again, it is not implemented into our systems and workflows, but there's also a discussion about whether we should do it or not. We tested the simple GUI and the command line, and everything works really fine for us. We tested the checking against standards. We haven't tested the checking against our custom policy because we simply don't have one. It uses XML for reports, so it's again easy to integrate into our other reports. It performs fast on a large amount of files. It has a web service where you can check your files against standards and also against policies that are published. And it also has a repair possibility. For example, if you have a frame and there's a bit flip, then you can just correct it once again. Okay. Yeah, I am very happy that we have all these tools to test and to help us validating the files so that we can help soon to be doctor and future me. Well, thank you. And
thank you, Merle. We should have time for about a question or two before Jimmy. Carl, if you want to just call it out and I can repeat the question. Carl Lugenhoyt.
I have a question. How do you validate the validation software?
How do you validate the validation software? That might be a question for all of us.
That's a really complicated question because you have to have a set of files that that is well known and that is described well, that fulfills the standard, and you know that it fulfills that. So my colleague Michelle Lindler has made a set of PDF files so that we can benchmark, for example, Jove, the tool that says if a PDF file is well-formed and valid or not. And it's really hard work to do that, and yeah, you have to put a lot of effort in it. And of course, you can also compare the validation software themselves. When there are more than one, you can just compare whether they are coming to the same result. And that's something, if you have the possibility to do this, then you should just try it out because there are really interesting outcomes.
Thank you.
Short addition to your answer, that is that Vera PDF project themselves are also building a test corpus for the tool itself. So you can, so you're building your own test corpus, but the project, the open source project, is also building a test corpus to validate their own software.
Thanks, Bert. Any other questions? Yeah, just from our perspective from the Irish Film Institute, I think we'd be very interested to talk to you about this because we're trying to do a very similar thing where we're doing all the validation ourselves and rejecting things, and it'd be great if they could do it themselves with some sort of a, and like, why not MediaConch, I guess.
Okay,
so thank you so much, Merle.